This is Zog in LA, who came to Earth from someplace else in his intergalactic space vehicle. Unfortunately, the scout ship failed to notify him of the toxic atmosphere in Los Angeles. He stopped on the street at a red stop signal. While waiting for it to change, he decides to raise the hood and have a look around. All it takes is one whiff and he passes out, just as the signal changes to go. The top of the signal is made of wood supported on a tubular brass pole. The signal flags are also wood. All of the linkages are concealed inside the pole. The body of Zog's flying saucer was turned on the lathe from a maple blank. It has a floor of tin plate. I spun the dome out of a copper sheet over this wooden mandrel. Here's another unpainted dome. If you don't know about metal spinning, check out the videos on YouTube. It's a very cool process. The dome is hinged to the body in back. Zog is made from little wooden beads and wire, painted in appropriate alien colors. The crankshaft is a brass rod with a wooden crank on it. The yellow crank handle spins, which makes it nice for cranking. The crank must be turned in only one direction for the action to work properly, so there's a wedge-style, one-way device fitted to the shaft. Also on the shaft is a split washer worm gear that turns a 15-tooth pinwheel gear. This, in turn, drives a second pinwheel gear of equal size, which operates the traffic signal. On the other end of the second gear's shaft is a small crank. This actuates a slotted arm that moves a rocking, over-centered device back and forth. This device is a triangular piece of brass pivoted in the center of its bottom side. A leg protrudes from each corner of the triangle. A tension spring is attached to the center one to keep it in position until the arm moves it again. Wire links attached to the other two legs go up the signal's pole to work its arms. On the shaft of the first pinwheel gear are two cams. The follower of the inner cam lifts the lid of the spaceship. The follower of the outer cam, just a simple eccentric, lets Zog fall on his face, then sits him back up again, as you can see here with the roof held back. The automaton's box is made of Baltic birch plywood, with the pieces dovetailed together without glue. All of the different actions had to be properly timed to make sense. With the red stop flag out, the dome of the spaceship rises, Zog succumbs, the red flag changes to green, the lid closes, and the green signal goes back to red. I've thought about some more misadventures for Zog in LA. They may ultimately happen. Stay tuned.